I woke up earlier than usual today, head swollen like pregnant flies caught in a spider web, and I think I'm just an insect on the sidewalk of this giant city block, where the sun comes up like a dysfunctional elevator, riding over the hills like a blind man on his bike. I need a seeing eye dog to help me out of bed, without tripping over these slippers that no one's worn in 4 years. The bedroom has a different texture this early in the morning. I enjoy sitting at my window. I've been watching all these people move like broken car parts. Black ants in a rat maze, gathering crumbs to bring home a full loaf of bread. The streets bump into each other, like this club's been open all night. People coming in, people going out. I haven't been to a funeral in a while. And I think it's because I can't stand the way my father sits when there's death and handshakes and hello hugs. He cries like he's singing, and I'd buy his album if he ever came out with one. He makes music with his tears, like I do, like rain in a tin can. Constant tapping, like a radiator shivers. Someone put a jacket on this house and feed me the static. Take my brain out and show it to me. Kids in the shape of pills. I wish I had wings that worked in water. I'd float my way home. What is this place? Sick of myself, throwing up in front of mirrors. I'm waiting for the carpet cleaner to put its foot down, because I'm not cleaning this mess. What is this place? My images now all have curfews, hibernating rituals where they leave me in the dark. Fuck the beat, no drums, no drums. Skin me and make a song for them, all of them to dance to, like cocaine lines with clogs on. Center of dance floors and strobe. Spin and grind every hour away, every hour that came before this one. We only exist at night with forgetful minds, and only the sound of this second clicking matters. I'm in line, single file, like we are. Folders with labels, organized like socks, obligated to mates, and will always fit in a drawer. Fuck this, I don't want to. Look at the rebel, let's exploit him. Tag his cheek to keep track of him. Barcoded and I need a SKU check over here. SKU check, somebody wants to purchase the X on the map. Clean out his wallet with the broomstick made of fallen trees and nappy angel hair. I need it spotless, and that means you too. Out, now. The house looks better without you in it anyways. Your crayons scribble on these antique walls, and I'm a loner that needs companionship. So last night I gave birth to my mind through my mouth, a child's brain, detached in a shopping cart, up and down aisles, down and up, back and forth, jittery wheels, forth and back. Don't listen to my music, or whatever it is. I don't want you to look like this. It's not fun, no, no fun. I wear a gas mask and a hard hat to sleep. Stay on your own yellow brick mission. There's sky falling from the clouds, peeling themselves from the sky. The sun takes a bath, and little pieces of confetti are thrown all over the black rug, until light vacuums its family room and opens its eye. What is this place? What? Please tell me. I'm sick. I seem to be comfortable in clothes that don't fit. I like playing games with no endings or overs. I keep cheating on myself, having affairs with attractive thoughts and persuasive clothing, running around naked with strangers and netting them like spiders. A thought stuck on flypaper, and she's the one that woke me up early this morning. She makes me hate my music. She tells me there's answers to every question, which I think is a trick. Yeah, she's a trick. Homeless, without a magician to push her back up his sleeve. She makes me try to express myself like I'm some sort of puppet to my brain, but I can't leave. I'm whipped, an addict to the way she thinks. I can see her ideas move through the traffic like water. She's a light bulb plugged into the wall outlet, my outlet, out of myself. I fuck her like a virgin, an unpeeled orange. She orgasms ink like a broken well, and my sheets are covered from head to footer. We smoke cigarettes in the dark together, and talk about mirrors and wheat fields and piano keys. We cuddle all night like two fetuses tied up by an umbilical cord. Then I leave her for another early morning to stare out windows and find a different partner, a different idea in a miniskirt, one that fits my high expectations.
Second verse in your head, do it.
Okay, ready? Go.
pepper shaker, still. A pile of dusty clothing on a sidewalk next to a paper cup with its palm out. He plays an instrument, sings to the city air like rain pellets hit the gutter, then the concrete, then gets muffled by $90 sneakers. His fingers around me like belts, worn leather, wrinkled, pressing notes, leaving fingerprints and sounds. Music, like a woman crying in her car, plucking me. Hollow sounds, like a little drummer boy pounding the roof with his fists. My head, like mallets on glass tables. Cymbals, like a car crashes. Bulb popping, dinner plates on linoleum. We move through the world like music, brushing shoulders. Songs with lips, dress shoes on tile floors. Nervous fingertips on wood desks. Painted nails on computer screens. It's all a song, we're symphonies without music stands. Memorizing conversations and pretending to be ourselves. A guitar-shaped woman scratching her stomach gently, a hole in her center and metal knobs on her face, one note at a time. A violin string flossing a tooth in a trumpet's mouth, a saxophone off the hook, a stuttering flute trying to relate to a cymbal. I fall asleep to the sound of my pen playing the paper. My brain sheds scales like a lizard on the xylophone. Skipping records, long days, the speaker is an open pore. Sweating, twisted jazz notes that read themselves out loud. The saxophone is throwing up in the sink, and I'm mesmerized by the sound of its dry heaving. The piano is leaving suicide notes behind, and I whistle along with them. Waiting for the viola to break through my car windows and pull me from the wheel. The cymbal crashes, and so do I. I bleed vinyl, black drool, worn out record, needle on track mark. It's like a piano and a cello making love to each other on top of a bass drum in my attic. Pulling my hair with a bow and singing with a broken reed. Her mind's one giant CD deck that won't stay in the dashboard. This life tastes like cardboard and I'm boxed in. Bandaged with packing tape and clothed in shipping labels. The moon plays the night and we all dance our way home from work. There's an entire orchestra in the car next to me and she keeps taking me out of the music. I just wanna fuck the cello until it's got me strung out on its strings, hanging damp like washed clothes, whispering at the sun. The music melts, this life tastes like chocolate, and I'm boxed in. If music had a brain, I'd pick it like a scab on a flower petal. I'm an out-of-tune instrument. There's worms at my core and the fishermen are out circling the orchard looking for second servant. Give me a plate full of inspiration and a cup full of gasoline. I'll need enough to drive my motivation to the next town before I can refill the tank with my broken down machine. My rusty purpose with two broken axles riding sideways on its hinges. If life was in the palm of my hands, I'd probably start cracking my knuckles and drop it. I'm a pale piece of loose leaf never written from the notebook I was nurtured in. An ocean that's been taken by its own waves. Lungs filled with seesaw. I'll need a dictionary to help me spell out help and a beach full of sand with a large enough opening to make myself visible to all the rescue ladders telling me I can climb. But in a world full of ceilings, the only stars I see have glue on their backs and I'm down to my last straw. So I sip on my days moderately and spend my nights on overpriced dreams. My mind's a wallet with thousands of pictures and nothing ever worth putting words to. Tomorrow has been in that dressing room for 4 hours, trying on the same cheap clothes it wore all day yesterday. And I think I'm going to die one day, but fuck it, I'll deny it until it leaves my laces untied. All these topics are quiet libraries with overdue discussions, and these whispering trendsetters need to stop tying up my phone lines. I pushpinned my heart to the wall and I nailed my brain to my notebook. I have trouble keeping my thoughts in line. This life goes far beyond the margins and all these ideas are just blown out bulbs. Staple my tongue to my ears and watch my pupils drop out of their classes. I've been forced fed with crooked spoons and now I'm an ironic silverware collector, selling myself to junkies who drool over my anguish, lined up to watch me crack my head open on microphones and bleed all over my new pants. A bunch of swaying light posts with dim eyes, anxious to see the stage open up and the turntables rise. Fiends for a dose of my depression with their sleeves rolled up, asking me to pass the needle. So if I can drown my own voice, I'd do it in a lake where no one could see me, because I think I like being alone. I'm a tightly packaged dress shirt, always hiding in the folds. On holidays, I throw my head in a grab bag because I want someone else to wear it. Fuck this deflating beach ball we've all decided to establish residency on. I hope someone kicks the ball out of bounds and beyond the stadium boundaries. A round-bellied planet, and we're all waiting for the fat lady to sing her solo, so we can have an excuse to say goodbye to these blue walls. I ride a dismantled bike that's bolted to the ground, and happiness keeps putting his fingers in the spokes, and I wish these walls never spoke. My life is a pair of pants, and I'm the pocket with the hole, digging myself out with the shovel and hopes of striking oil, so I can loosen up these wheels, and I'd push the pedals all night to a place where a seamstress would work overtime on patching up my life. I ride a dismantled bike that's bolted to the ground, and happiness keeps putting his fingers in the spokes, and I wish these walls never spoke. My life is a pair of pants, and I'm the pocket with the hole, digging myself out with the shovel and hopes of striking oil, so I can loosen up these wheels, and I'd push the pedals all night to a place where a seamstress would work overtime on up my life. I scotch taped my mind to the bedpost and sold my soul to the nightstand. This place goes nowhere beyond the wallpaper, and all these patterns are just overused Rorschach designs. If this room was a woman, I'd call her a wishing well and throw myself inside her like a new penny. But her coven is far from warm bathwater, rather a funnel of crushed ice, and I'm falling like hail from the horizons, like bad dreams shaken from morning hair. I'm paging the rooster 911, telling him to quickly bring out the sun so I can better see the sidewalk. My body's an egg carton with cupped hands around my fragile wine glass. My perspective's half empty and I've got bright dreamy eyes, like flashlights with imaginations. My pillow has a trap door that I fall into after an hour of tallying my breath, so I'll never change my pillowcase, and we're just stick figures in the hands of amateur architects, spending nights over drawing boards making floor plans for my tomorrows. But the sunset is pink and I'm planning a picnic for me and my inhibitions. I carry food for thought in my basket case mind and eat my words every time I leave my zipper undone. There's blood in my phlegm and cracks in my walls that remind me of veins, and if I could find the heart in this place, I'd put its neck in a blanket and hang it from the ceiling light. I need shades for my perspectives and a windowsill for my flower pot concepts. Talking to myself is like performing for hundreds of people. I'm just a mic stand being stared at on stage. Everything I say is just feedback because I'm the only one swallowing my bland convictions. Like a fly, I'm attracted to the spotlight. I'm hanging from the walls in my fly zapper bedroom that has this less than meditative hum to it. A high pitch tossing curveballs to my mind, and I'm the batter without a helmet outrunning the bases over and over because I can't find my way home. Put my brain in a folder and take me to class. Take me out of my Tupperware container and safety pin me to the clouds. Leave me out to dry. Put a real estate sign outside my notebook and prostitute my thoughts to the public. I need some gratification and a pack of cigarettes to fill my lungs with some life. Decapitate my loneliness and carry my carcass from the bedroom. Leave the door open a crack because we all know that sooner than later I'll definitely be back. So where's my damn bike at? Get me the hell out of here. I need air in my tires and a bucket full of tears so I can drown my frowns every time the sun decides to go down. I ride a dismantled bike that's bolted to the ground, and happiness keeps putting his fingers in the spokes, and I wish these walls never spoke. My life is a pair of pants and I'm the pocket with the hole, digging myself out with the shovel and hopes of striking oil so I can loosen up these wheels. And I'd push the pedals all night to a place where a seamstress would work overtime on patching up my life. light a dismantled bike that's bolted to the ground, and happiness keeps putting his fingers in the spokes. And I wish these walls never spoke. My life is a pair of pants, and I'm the pocket with the hole, digging myself out with the shovel and hopes of striking oil so I can loosen up these wheels. And I'd push the pedals all night to a place where a seamstress would work overtime on patching up my life.
Quiet nights of quiet stars, quiet chords from my guitar.
She listens to the static on the radio, sitting straight up in a chair, pulling each tangled ball of insecurity off her pants. Black attracts lint and gloom attracts attention, unwanted. She lives between walls, framed by peeling wallpaper and stained ceiling tiles. A painting never acknowledged good enough by the artist to be shown. The forgotten child at a public festival by its parents, you watched cry in the corner. The milk vest denied notice and goes sour. She plays solitaire with the deck missing cards. The clock snaps its fingers with repetition and claps its hands on the hour, every hour. The lamp reminds her of winter, and she thinks of an album she used to play in her car. The music was adored, and if it had to be described, it was wood, the soft-looking wood that was crafted by a perfectionist that probably bit his nails and owned a camera, maybe smoked cigarettes and lived in a one-bedroom apartment. She broke the antenna on purpose one night after cooking dinner for herself, but the radio is still friendly. Pastime backyards are kept clean cut in small picture frames around the room. Faded photos she chooses to remember, the ones that come sugar-coated without bad aftertaste. Easy to swallow, hard to deny, wrapped decently in fake smiles and crooked teeth. She's a jogger that never leaves her room, keeps everyone across the map, puts on makeup at 10:30 at night, and watches the mirror. She needs the mirror like it needs her, like her fingers need an occupation, a purpose. And if it wasn't pulling lint off her appearance, it would probably be sewing tablecloths or overcoats. She flips through books, never reading the middle chapters, only the endings. Eats three meals a day, washes her clothes, brushes her teeth, will die at age 67. And tells her children that this earth we're all just leasing has bad phlegm. Uneasy stomach, empty milk gallon, juggle my heart and my brain. The audience claps to the beating of my childhood, backlashed by belts, welted principles through eyes undotted, cross my mind like jaywalking through writer's blocks. I stop at a fruit stand to pick up an orange. Imagine your entire life was selling fruit to strangers, watching them unpeel your purpose right in front of you, then walking away. Backs turned, drifting down the sidewalk like dry leaves that were dropped from their mother's arms and twigged fingers. I only like to listen to female vocalists because they take the place of my mother. So here I am, a full-grown candlestick with fire in my eyes, standing in puddles of myself. Cutting scissors along dotted lines, sign your name, then break the pen in half, throw it on the floor. Faces floored, unaware of what's in store. And we're in stores around the world ordering heroes to help us. Breaking news over my knee, let the whips crack. And now people are falling in crevices, getting backhanded by their own children. And America knows the back of its hand like the back of its hand. Buckle down on evil and strap on your seatbelt. There's people speaking in tongues, I listen in ears. And I wish this mute button would just fucking work. Saran wrap cocoon people, well packaged and ready for inspection stickers. All in lines waiting for the instructions pamphlet. Somebody incidentally left out of the box. Grab your boots and laces and pray for a shortage of chalk so we're never stuck between lines. People painted on sidewalks by bad artists with broken brushes. And civilian eyewitnesses wearing wristbands to let the blind bartenders know that they can drink. Oh, this beverage on the rocks, stuck between a hard place. Artificially flavored with sour blood, cut with water, diluted by salt grains and decorated with paper umbrellas. My machine gun voice drowns out your non-swimmer handgun ass. Shallow end of the gene pool screen.
We're power.
Clenched fists, steroid bicep, dog tag, leash, phallus construct, penis high, economically more erect, Viagra for your gap teeth, poverty-stricken housewife, briefcase army of hopeless ants, javelin bent promised land, reconstruct our lives, simply to be remembered after we're dead, time capsules, well recommended to be taken with a full glass of bullshit, and before a meal off, silver plates at dinner tables where children are forced there with crooked spoon. We are riflemen, hunters with wives and ovens and children in pleated skirts at a give me your future in a wooden box boarding school. Place blame wherever it seems to fall. Grants open the cage, dress in triangular plastic flags. We hang food overhead, leave you under impressions. Watch you salivate while we ostracize your beating heart and make you feel unwelcome in your own head. A rotten tooth in the world's mouth, tie it to door number 3 and just wait for opportunity to start knocking. Venom dripping on laminated placemats, critical leaks in the roof of a mouth. Where we must find the root canal. Fuck it if it really fits into our puzzle. The puzzle with the pieces that aren't even aware that they exist on a board. Extra sales on American flag prints and head bandanas. A village bully with a jock strap around his skull, which belongs to a skeleton, kept in a walk-in closet, lynched by twisted hangers. The attic of a country with off-scented mothballs and dead-bolted chests. Stuck out with pride, the big man on campus, in a university of midget-minded fools. Puppet strings played like fiddles. The ventriloquist makes the wooden people drink a full glass of water, and our backbones rot. We need sore thumbs to point fingers at, and digits to pull triggers. Keep them clenched. Patriotism is at risk. No hangnails, only fine groomed cuticles. Sitting ducks waiting for the nail clippers to attack, so we can pull out our penises and cock back. Phallus constructs blasted, and we've got missiles for arms. Let's cut off the limbs and watch the leaves fall. Yes, I'm well read, but best way through. A military of green cap people screaming go. Chaos is in the back pocket of order, and I can't find my ID card. It makes me think of warm food in a flower pot. We're good liars, bad expressionists, but very well entertained. Make the popcorn and get new batteries for the remote. It's a drive-in, but we're on the screen getting driven out by concepts about cars. Walk the plank, choose which side of the fence. Walk a fence, tame the offense with its elbow pads on the tables. Don't trust my morality in its privates. Where's the greener grass? And we're all on pilgrimages, searching for the Miracle-Gro gardeners. I'm a brick in a wall that's getting spray painted by a graffiti artist that lost his mind when he found his reason next to the blank notebook on the floor of his room where he once hung posters of idols. We all wake up in the morning trying to be. Salute the button pusher, wheel of fortune spinner, police distributor, Q-33 bombing industrial smiley faces, necktie and slip knots, panties and bunches, high caste systems and fuck the underachievers. Sound the horns and mute the thinkers. Sign your name. Bought a table no one sits at. She makes phone calls and says nothing. Picture a goldfish, one eye, in a 6-ounce cup, no water. What is the square root of a circle without a face? And how do you change a penny? One senseless mind on one track. The table's used as a symbol for family. It suffices. Hi, I'm here because it's the correct thing to do, not because I want to enjoy myself. I walked to the store and traded in my happiness for first quality clothing. I wear them around, out to dinner parties, barbecues, even in the shower. I've tricked myself into believing I'm a magician. I guess I am. It's like saving all your life to die with nothing. It's just the concept that matters, like planning a vacation. I'm a plan book, a journal bought, never written in. I built this brand new house to live in 3 days before I died. Concepts. But what happens when I move into a solitary confinement cell with no down payment and a mortgage rate to die for? I'll never fall asleep if you walk out now, but it would probably be more like getting dragged like a small fragile child or a Newport 100 getting close to the filter. I'll never clean this ashtray, make this bed, or vacuum the carpet. I'm scared and scared to say it. The world and everything that surrounds me is a giant Halloween mask I can never look at in the store because it reminded me of shit I never knew. No, don't accelerate at green because I'm following close behind and that car coming from the left is totally disregarding the red. I'm stuck on yellow, hoping to be charismatic enough for others to mock me, but I seem to be the only existing snail on a field of lizards, the only speed limit sign on a highway of impatient blind drivers. It's all moving too fast and I can't find the stop button. It's not a movie, we're not stars, and you won't even be given enough credit to appear in the credits. It will all pass, and I'll be in the car with the staring driver. But I don't want it to. It seems like we've just met, and I can still remember how much you valued family. The way we sat at dinner, the way you never wanted anyone to know when you were hurt. The early days, and I hope my cries come home tardy. The first impressions and second guesses, third degree burns, and I still want to anticipate the forthcoming albums, the high notes and low notes, the second guessing because at least we're guessing it all. And I'll put my hand on the stove for a third of the time we spent together to replace the emptiness I fear that I hide from in closets, under clothes, trying to break the knob and hope someone comes to find me, someone that looks like you. And there's no clones or good enough impressionists to wear your smile like you do. So back when I would give you a hard time, I just wanted to be held by your attention, cupped in your fingers like falling water. I'll be the faucet all day if you keep washing your face. And I don't want to write anything that looks like this again, at least not this soon. So please, keep calling.
Thank you.
and I'm wrapped with myself. My mind's a rubber band, always snapping to the tunes I used to hear on the radio. The radio is a room and I'm trapped up inside, running my head into the walls, just trying to stay alive. I knew you never understood me, pretending to catch my lines. I'm alone in a body that wants to kill its own mind, and I'm wrapped with myself. My mind's a rubber band, always snapping to the tunes I used to hear on the radio. The radio is a room and I'm trapped up inside, running my head into the walls, just trying to stay alive. I knew you never understood me, always pretending to catch my lines. I'm alone in a body that wants to kill its own mind. This is a hula hoop contest, the ring around the Rose Garden Festival, where we avoid the thorns and fiend for the petals. Metal made men made in China's black market backyards, guarding doors and windows I just can't get inside myself. Lately I felt withdrawn and exiled, drawing blanks from the faces of drawn out days, looking in mirrors that reflect the stranger. So I never talk to myself unless my mother's not looking. I'm looking for a cause because I need the effects. I'm a gratification junkie that just won't accept its own reflect. Shunned by my own light, I'm searching to find darkness. Give her my ring and make her my wife. I wanna fuck spider webs and have children that won't be bugged. Become one with my image so I'm never perceived as too much of anything. Start collecting pushpins to mark maps of my soul so I never get lost again without a way out. Load up my car, wash off the windows, clear the driveway and lock myself inside. But I've come to find that my car, well, it's kinda like my inspiration. Out of gas with a flat tire, trying to fuck the parking spot it married 4 years ago, but too impotent to finish off anything. So I just sit in it and check myself out in the rearview mirror, dwelling on a fogged up past. And I'm wrapped up with myself. My mind's a rubber band, always snapping to the tunes I used to hear on the radio. The radio is a room and I'm trapped up inside, running my head into the walls, just trying to stay alive. I knew you never understood me, always pretending to catch my lines. I'm alone in a body that wants to kill its own mind. And I'm wrapped up with myself. My mind's a rubber band, always snapping to the tunes I used to hear on the radio. The radio is a room and I'm trapped up inside, running my head into the walls, just trying to stay alive. I knew you never understood me, always pretending to catch my lines. I'm alone in a body that wants to kill its own mind.
Criticism is thick, my high beams seem to be dim. I'm putting paper bags on my face and suction cupping my image to the fridge. I'm senseless, trying to buy gumballs and help them call home. Always running short and wishing I was a little bit taller. Holding constipated pens that refuse to take a laxative. I've taken out my spinal cord and attached it to a guitar. I play myself over and over, but I still can't learn the words. I need a karaoke machine and a teleprompter. I'm losing sleep, staying up all night, writing letters on my eyelids, trying to help my brain burp and my heart cough up its phlegm. Expressing myself is what keeps me myself, but lately I haven't been myself and I don't know how to express that. So I wander the streets in search of the express train, but there's no fast way out of here. I'm stuck under flesh, poking and prying. It's just me in a mic stand, having a staring contest under a spotlight of the wrong color. I'm seen under buzzing light bulbs that came out the womb of strobe in a hospital bed next to neon. I'm a black light called tie-dye. Blow my eyes, I wipe my tears with tissues. That's really my shirt, so I walk around wearing my feelings. I button my heart to my sleeve. It's laminated and mass-produced, but everyone's dyslexic and reads me wrong.
I've got wet feet and a strong urge to cry, but nowhere to drip into. Cookie cutter images of my chocolate chip wants and dreams. I'm a lost page from a book, asking directions back to my daily bind from a gas station attendant pumping his own heart with a broken nozzle. Bookworms on fish hooks, food for my full plate of too much to take care of in a day, overpacked weeks, bulging suitcase of a life in a fishbowl with card sharks gambling myself away. But I keep an objective fisheye lens perspective, an optimist that missed all these suicide kings poking their queens in the heart for a self-esteem booster. Power sits on two telephone books with its elbows on the dinner table. All this feet tapping and knuckle cracking make a bad instrumental for our bland conversations. We all make small talk and buy large mirrors for our bedrooms.
Big and tough and macho, you can kick my ass. So fucking what?
beginning. Fuck, I can't find my way home. Fuck, fuck, I can't find my way home. Fuck, I can't find my way home. There's a fly in my salad, a rip in my t-shirt, a stain on my name tag, fog in my glasses. Excuse me, here's a napkin. You've got some testosterone hanging from your lip there. Oh look, he's dressed up as a bicep today, how cute. And he's even taught his dick to speak, coming out of profile to fit his profile, slapping his tongue in the air, saliva swirling. What's with those, you're wearing there? Poke me with a fork, you dumb fucking rhetoric. Shoot up, mommy drip juice fell out the loose ionic cooking pot, latex pot holders. Push and squeeze, push and squeeze. We've got a beautiful cliche here. Two balls and where's the hoop? He's got a long belt and no pants, so he goes around beating people who looks like him when he was small. Yeah, it feels good and manly. Masculine silhouettes, the son of an alcoholic moon who stayed out at bars all night and came home walking through the door like a fatigued, wrinkled condom, slouched and used slippers, huh? Come on, you can do better than that. Put some oomph into it. I get my character deficiencies from my father. Sport workout tape with legs, and the only place I feel at home is on the playing field. I just got out of the gym. Okay, now stop making a good time out of his clothing. You smitching of hope. Hey, you stepped on my shoe, fucker. Pull out your Y chromosome and let's play show and tell. Here's a good icebreaker standing over there. Look at this kid. Ha! Come on, girl, watch this. I'll make him look different by lumping up his fucking face. Thinks he's big time like some overinflated, arrogant wristwatch or something. Using all those big words. Watch me expose my insecurities by showing you how I make myself feel better. What the fuck are you looking at? I must be some sort of piece of finger food to make this dumbbell ironing board pull out his tongue like that, picking on me. All right, wait, calm down and count up to 10. Put your peanut board back in the wall socket. Settle down and just use the napkin I gave you a little bit earlier, okay? Oh, and yeah, motherfucker, I usually don't write shit like this. Oh, look, now he's justifying himself again. Don't hate me because I'm suitable to become the laughing stock on the trading floor. I paid these whores and wasted time to brainstorm and try to come up with the best one-liner they can. Little boys trying to be men and pairs of pantyhose watering down their remarks. I don't suffer. I enjoy watching them try hard to get in that girl's pants. Fuck the fuck-offs and piss-ons. Insecurity had a child that named it you. Ha! Believe in yourself and you can accomplish anything as long as it's directly related to the humiliation of me. He talks weird and silence makes sense. Patience is a word I've learned to use along with ignore. You're a big whore. Good one, thesaurus, man. Unintelligible, eligible bachelor with three sluts on the side in case of backlashes for mediocre punchlines. People like you are like people like you. Get it through that thick head, dickhead. Follow those rats that are chasing the piper in search of cheesy solutions. The conclusion is at the end of the book, stupid. Read up and re-up on that drug called macho. You fucking skipped a couple chapters. I don't stutter, I speak your language. Hi, take that middle finger of yours and stick it up where you talk at him. Those clothes are so yesterday. Look at the car he's driving. Look in the mirror and call yourself a sexy bitch. Faggot, pretentious pieces of shit. You walked out of the dump without a guardian. Your Freudian concepts are as necessary as that tattoo is. Taboo sick, the pleasant sight of your failure doesn't reimburse me. I smell insignificance, masked by the cheap cologne you use to try and hide that manly body odor. I'll give you some change to call your mom and tell her you've made a new friend named Acceptance. Shit, he gave you the wrong number. I feel for you. Is it that time of the month again for idiotic comments spewed out of the mouth of someone in self-denial? I'll take the abuse. You get that noose ready. Don't forget to kill yourself when you get home. Sticks and stones may break my bones, but words don't do anything but assure me of your small dick size, imbecile. window shutters blink. Caution, the dam in your sockets may overflow. Open eye ducts bleed stains on my shirt. Anger has its period. Trip on a pad, I draw question marks. Music is playing in the sandbox with the shovel. I've been digging the same hole since I came out of one. Exclamation point. It's been a black and white Polaroid warped by leaking faucet. And I wish these damn memories would learn to cry for themselves. Heirlooms pass down the table, blowing off wigs, reach for the salt. I'm a family broken at the seams. Thread knotted and a needle without an eye. I'll build my own fucking haystack. Where's the quit button and the promising tomorrows that slept in my playpen? Left to go right in a maze without corners. Paradise has paper umbrellas and I never swallowed the side dishes. Undercooked bedtime stories. Lullabies without kisses or curdled dreams. And she's beautiful in her crevices. The creases and folds, the cup of her ass. But baggy clothes and mittens keep me from drinking. She wears herself inside out to tease me. Brain like clockwork, mechanics plucking, springs churning, it's my downfall. And I follow gestures like batons, drunk circles doing themselves undone, veins tied around my neck. You strangle bottlenecks and find climax in empty bottoms, connected by wires, down throat alcohol swabs. Put a cork in it, you need to take care of your problems. Give them an ice pack and bandage their mouths shut. I can't hear myself shut up, mine hiccups. Sing from the top of your lungs, then jump, because I need to watch. This house is a river, and you were always too couch-stuffed to teach me to swim. Tired of waking up, down, wet, dying every morning is like an open shower curtain. My painting is smeared, and I was always terrible at revision, but good at staying in touch with my emotions. We're pen pals that hate each other, but glued at the seams. Play me like a fiddle, tie my strings around your finger, then tickle my brain until it falls out of its bedroom. Fuck your farewell waves and pretty postcard shorelines. How could I say goodbye when good is a relative term and everybody's using it, but I can't relate to them. My blood must be green and my family must be a bush. I've been trapped in a backyard thinking about how your forehead wrinkles, Indian style, in a sandbox with more dirt than sand. The scent of candy yams and daffodils that have the word spring tattooed to their ankles, doing a three-legged race towards my open door. Morning. And it looks like garbage dumpsters that redress by cesspools when I walk outside. One foot on the planet's back and the other on carpet that needs to be washed. The air tastes like cotton candy that took a bath with sweet pickles spiced with whatever I think grass would taste like. 6 a.m. And I'm off to pretend I know what I'm doing. Put on my tight sweater vest I bought in the conformity outlet, and I'm off to mechanically separate smiles with my well-dressed counterparts and shoot up vials of artificial intelligence so my half hour breaks. I'm unemployed in the mind, but my body's a store mannequin 40 hours a week. Without this job, my week would be an empty glass with one annoying crack that needs to be filled with something. So I might as well rise with the sun and pretend we all have a purpose to live out. Get up, get out, and give our time to the grandfather clock in exchange for a paper or plastic bag stuffed with lifetime achievements. Let's all live out the next door neighbor's dreams and get a pat on the back for being well behaved. Here's a biscuit for being my billboard, and we're all poster children taught to hang out with the rich kingpins. It's opera conditioning in cubicles, and our favorite color is green. Tighten your neckties and go add to a traffic jam on an interstate highway nearest you. Corporatist. Give me a percentage off and I've got it on. Nice and trim, buttoned up and enough to hide my face. Who wears the pants? Iron mines blowing steam, folded on the creases. I'll bury you in your loopholes. The sight of grown humans in a circle, Indian style, playing duck, duck, goose. Who's the oddball we can toss around the ping pong table? I'm tired of trying on pants and hemming my thoughts to fit into a shoe that's never been my size. She's more than just lunch breaks and drive-through meals, personal phone calls and fake sick days. Life, and it looks like Webster dictionaries that redress by thesauruses when I go inside. punch the clock, knuckle up, and think about kicking the manager in the face. The days are like left out milk in your mother's favorite glass, and people who will only eat from one specific plate. We're all Chinaware waiting for a second serving, but someone's gotta scoop the corn. I wonder if when I was two I ever thought it would be like this. Childhood in mismatched socks, running through the grass, the limits, the boundaries, grass stains and cuts on knees. Now it's 24-hour planners, coffee stains and pay cuts. A big cycle, and we're all in a whirlwind that lost its spin, swimming doggy paddle towards a boat with no oars. And we'll do anything for a stage, even if it's under construction with ripped curtains and bad lighting. We're all in a dark room wearing sunglasses and black clothes, trying to act developed but getting angry at whoever steps on our toes. Misery loves company, and I'm in the kitchen fixing hors d'oeuvres. We live in a cafeteria, sitting at tables where we feel welcome. We're all in the same arena, just eating different refreshments from whichever concession stand treats us best. All up on alarm cackles, in the shower and out the door. But my mind is fucked, and not ready to birth a new way of life. So I abort my fears and pretend comfort fits me like the shirt I bought for work. To work 5 days out of a 7-day week at a hated job, but supposedly I'd love to make money. Bulging wallets and gaudy old ladies, the scent of farina and baby's breath that have gang signs burst into their backs. Doing a drive-by past my open window, the alarm clock. Like chirping birds muzzled by tint and the respirator that's been installed in my dashboard. I don't even know how I make it there, but I do, every day, every time the sun opens its cataract eye. It's like a record with Tourette syndrome, stuttering and drooling. Each day has needle marks on its face, like a war heroin junkie that sells his body and masks his face. We all wear potato sacks, and someone's got a gun that yells start when it's pushed too far. And we all race until 3 seconds before the finish line, when we realize we've done nothing yet. All together now.
Have you ever confused a dream with life? Or stolen something when you have the cash? Have you ever been blue?
I think he knows I've been taking cigarettes from his ashtray every night after he hangs up his heart with his robe. I smoke because I like the shadows it makes on my walls. And there's a whole pack of kids out there crying in their rooms right now, tired of being put out on the sidewalk. We are slowly burning cigarettes, losing little pieces of ourselves each day. Our ends are filtered through fables we've been pretending for centuries. Smoke me until it burns your fingertips. There's an ashtray that lies on its back, sunbathing with no soap in the corner of my porch. It's like this burial ground for dead conversations. I once met this man who could blow out question marks, and I never understood what it meant. He said he smokes because he likes watching his breath float away. I'm a cloud trying to shape up and touch the ceiling. When it's quiet, I sit on my floor with an ashtray on my lap and smoke the two drags left on each cigarette lying in their cemetery. Eventually, I can hear ignitions turning over and cars starting, like people preparing themselves for another day. And I want to leave, float through my window, and fly away. If I was a room, I'd rush out my walls for a person to jump out of myself. If I was a room, I'd knock down my walls for a person to jump out of myself. If I was a room, I'd knock down my walls for windows to jump out of myself.
Today has turned to ash again. I ash my cigar on my garden, and I'm just a bed trapped inside your cage like heart-shaped birds with broken wings. I broke my mind on the edge of...
waving goodbye to my not-so-baby powder-fresh problems. Her round hills with nipples like water wells. Her breasts like sand buckets on skin-colored shorelines. I'm a coloring book without lines, and she's a pack of crayons. Colored wax with wicks long as the nights we've spent tied up in each other's thread. Unraveling from our pincushion hearts, hit the hay to become two needles in the stack. She caught my eye as if I had thrown it to her. Time flies with a wingspan of 4 feet hanging out from under bed sheets, where the street ends and we stare at the sky like we've never seen it before. Blow out the stars like candles. This place is a fern garden, and I play around in the rose patch, stretching her petals apart and pulling on her stems. Tongues with legs like joggers off sidewalks. Puddles and potholes splash around like water bugs. Flower pot G-spots in gardens with tools. Chapstick on tulips on top soil overturned. I've got thorns stuck in the skin of my memory, like bubblegum on walls. Stick to me like Velcro. Cast a connecting flight at 9 p.m. We can play horseshoes with the sun rays. You can paint me night and outline your day around me, like shadows in the shape of soda bottles. Spill me out for the dead moments lost, and drink me up for the life we've caught in fishing nets like fireflies with 100-watt ideas. Her wood-burning oven is heating my whole house, and I perspire from my eyes. The way she moves makes my tongue trip over itself, and I want to eat meals off her breastplate and stick a straw in her heart. She's an eyelash on my carpet. She's been saving all her dandelions for a heart implant and a mind reduction, soul-searching with a butterfly net and an old mayonnaise jar. I want to be her canvas. I'll be a burgundy spot on her blackness. I want her to paint me with her eyes shut. Genius, the one who creates the puzzle or the one who solves it? start washing the dishes. And my anxiety had to make a noose out of shoestring. I want my frustration to learn to fuck tranquility. And I want a sedative for my irritability. And I want an ability to erase myself from the treasure map. I want an excuse for my reasoning to go home with my logic. And a staple gun to give to my lack of attention span. I want to learn how to read books backwards. And write my autobiography from the ending. I want to sweet talk the seasons into coming home with me. I want to plant metal flowers and learn to grow up the hard way. I want to erase the ashtray from my deck so my anxiety stops shivering. And I want to paint a landscape on my window so my pain stops trying to get inside. I want to break all these pencils and use the lead for a bullet, then write my name on its back so I can touch someone's life. I want to be the train in your head and the passenger sitting inside, the rain in a puddle and the tear on your cheek every time you decide to cry. I'm the aspirin you swallowed and the pride you washed it down with. The summer that burnt through your ego's tanning lotion. I'm the offbeat drummer in my chest. I'm the cotton club support capitalism deep throater. The Karl Marx grass planter. Utopia on a bumper sticker theme song. I'm the worn soul in the shoe you couldn't fit into. The lines between the words and all the people waiting in them. I'm the world on steroids throwing around other planets. I'm Mother Earth divorcing the grandfather clock. I'm a thief taking my words back. And I'm a broken heart in a sling. I'm a girl who throws up in the toilet. And a family man who prays before meals. I'm a microwave dinner. An undercooked and overprocessed set of moral standards. A checking account with unbalanced distribution of rights. I'm making molehills out of mountains. I'm bird shit on the window of opportunity. And the only thing knocking at my door is loneliness. I'm the night to undress the TV with your eyes. I'm the blind, jealous of the windows. I'm the garbage bag dry humping the wind. The cavity tooth in a comb used to groom society's mind. And I'm the glitch in the system. The Cisco food product of an environmental gang rape. The white robe bent up halo printed security blanket. The nail in the splintered nation of cross-eyed taxi cab drivers. I'm a pair of glasses with a crack in my perception. And I'm a broken toddler's toy left in the kitchen garbage. Cramped under all these leftovers questioning my purpose. I am a thing, writing something and wondering who the fuck I am. I want to stop my heart from beating up my brain. I want to be a streetlight and block out the darkness. I want to buy a unicycle for love and be its drive. I want a half-hour break and 2 weeks worth of healthy days. A paid-for afterlife and a sneak preview trailer for purgatory. I want to understand comprehension and get braces for my vices. Give a nicotine patch to my cigarette pack and drink my bottled-up beers. I want to tell him that his goals are just metal poles in a net. And I want to give him a pair of brand-new cleats. I want to be a superstar with a light switch and a battery in the sun. I want this song to remind you of a moment in your life, and I think I want too much. I need a burner in my mind so I can record my thoughts. I want her to write all over herself and jump in an envelope. I want to mail myself to the post office. I want her not to cry every day. I want the speakers to stop popping, the ears to stop ringing, and the phone to hang itself up from the ceiling fan. I want fans, or do I? I want to think myself away. I want the Federal Bureau to get something in its eye. I want to write a world and move into it. I want a rent-free mind and a common fee that's just sense. I want a moving van for my abandonment issues and an empty fish tank for all of my tears. I want a belt for when I decide to hold up my memory banks and a baggage check for all the luggage under my eyes. I want to teach my clock to work with its hands and find the sleep I lost 3 nights ago. I want the division between church and state to multiply itself into recognition and all of these good church-going conditioner bottles to stop washing their hair. I want sandals for the amount of feet between here and home and a welcome mat for the dirty souls trying to break into my kitchen. I want to eat inspiration for dinner and wash it down with black ink. I want to fire the wind and hire the earth as my typist and write a life for myself and send it to an editor. I'm a salary trying to cut itself and drown corporate worlds in my blood. I'm a needle trying to shoot itself and overdose to my own vanity. I'm a padded wall trying to seize the moment. I'm an air conditioner trying to vent itself. And I'm a loaded gun trying to get all of this anger out. I'm a skyline trying to reach its limit and a popping speaker that's taking speech classes. I'm a thing writing something and wondering who the fuck I am. We'll be right back. I want to fall asleep next to my life and watch it snore all night. I need a reality check made out to cash and a trumpet player to follow me around each day. Do starving artists use their change to buy lunch or CDs? I want a stage made of food and an audience with ears that work. I need a woman shaped like a candle holder and a mother who can blossom leaves, a father who can grow fruit, and a full milk gallon in my refrigerator. Imagine your entire life was selling your problems to strangers, watching them unwrap your purpose right in front of you, then drifting away like shrink wrap in the wind down the sidewalk.
Boarding up my windows and putting lipstick on my walls. The sun goes down like a depressed man drowning in his bathtub. I've got the cello tied up to my bed with dirty socks, and I'm ready to fall asleep with my arms around its neck. I find comfort in music, but the drums won't face my problems. So I broke my Walkman on the pavement and walked away like a man wearing jogging shoes and a peace sign button. There's misplaced street signs, and that's a metaphor, but I can't find it. The directions are obsolete, and I'm a turned down stereotype that won't stop at a gas station for assistance. I'm a one-man show that won't give up the ball, but I can't dribble, so I lose, traveling without a carry-on, wandering my existence for a shelter. So it's over, it's done, complete. Lock the sliding door and set the alarm. Get undressed and turn off the television. The lamp goes out and nobody tucks in my sheets. The radio plays softly like a piano with laryngitis. Background noise for my upfront dreams of becoming a highway with punctuation when I grow up. I've got my license to be human in my pocket, and I can't wait to bump into the painter who's been coloring everything in blue. The neighbor's light just got turned off, and I see the world from a soundproof box. There's no real conversation, just moving lips and over-exaggerated gestures. The wind bullies around the plants outside. If I get at least an hour of sleep.
One night stand.
Crowded tune.
Instrument.
Room.
Blue.
Wallpaper.
One night stand.
Crowded tune.
Instrument.